All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Mr. David Fry.
Thank you. All right, you got me? You know, every time I get introduced to come up on stage, I chuckle, I laugh when I hear, introducing Dave Fry, because, you know, I think of myself being at home, taking out the garbage, telling my kids to, you know, do their homework, and it always makes me laugh when I hear that stuff. So today, we're going to talk about how to create a blogging system that will allow you to reach out to people and have them get to know you. But before I do that, I want you to get to know me a little bit. So let me see if my technical stuff here works. Go ahead and start the video. All right. Well, you can see it, but you cannot hear it.
Like a house of cards, one blow from caving in. Do you ever feel already buried deep? 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing. Do you know that there's still a chance for you? Cause there's a spark in you. You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just
a little bit about me. I just wanted you guys to get to know me a little bit, so you kind of know what my real passions are in life, and that's my family. So I am not seeing anything up here, and this thing isn't going forward on my computer either. Can you guys see it? All right, so while they're getting their stuff together, thank you very much. Well, and my time's not going anywhere either, so I can stay up here for quite a while. All right, there we go. And I am probably going to need, did you put my clicker in? No, you didn't. There it is. No wonder. See, if I wasn't so internet savvy. All right, cool. Let's go ahead and start. These $2 bills are not the same, all right? Because one of the $2 bills I get from network marketing, and the other dollar bill I get from internet marketing. A little bit about me, I started doing internet marketing back in 2000. I've been a full-time internet marketer ever since. I started network marketing in 2005, and I do both of those things. I've never been full-time in network marketing, although I make a very, very, very good living in my network marketing business. And so I look and I compare, you know, my internet marketing business to my network marketing business. And that's where I'm coming from when I talk about this. You know, the money that I get from my network marketing business, I call beach money. How many of you have read the book Beach Money by Jordan Adler? Mr. Jordan Adler, where are you, Jordan? Stand up. There's one of my mentors, the author of Beach Money. If you guys have not got the book, you need to do that. But the money that I make from internet marketing, I call my hustle money, because you're constantly having to hustle to get that money, doing joint ventures, setting up landing pages, looking over the pay-per-clicks, and doing all that. It's constant hustle to make it money. Now, I make good money in my internet marketing business, but there's a lot of hustle behind it. And a lot of the internet marketers out there will agree with me. But my network marketing business, that's not true. You know, Joel Peterson is here. Where are you, Joel? Good friend of mine. He's a very well-known internet marketer. I remember him, I can't remember how the conversation was going one day, but he asked me, or I said, ask me, Joel, how did that question go? Go ahead and say that question. This is really good. I mean, this is, you know, Joel had seen me in internet marketing for a long time, and he saw me doing network marketing, but he never wanted to do the network marketing part, right? And I was always, you know, talking to him about it, but he never wanted to do it.
So we were down at my house about last summer, and David said, Joel, we were talking about, you know, network marketing and internet marketing, and I just couldn't see it, you know, the vision. And he said, Joel, let me show you one thing. All you need to do is let me ask you
this question. So Joel, how much money did you make on your first sale in internet marketing? And I had to think, you know, my first sale in internet marketing, I made $37. And then Dave said, well, ask me that same question. Ask me how much I made on my first sale in network marketing. I said, Dave, how much did you make on your first customer in network marketing? And he said, Joel, I don't know the answer to that, because I'm still making money from my first customer in network marketing.
That's right.
And by the way, that was the defining moment for me to decide to get into network marketing. So thank you, Dave.
Isn't that cool? Thanks, Joel. By the way, me and Joel are college buddies. We knew each other back in, a long, long time ago in college. And here he is joining me in the business so many years later. It's awesome. I love MLM because also we receive recognition and appreciation. And who doesn't love to receive recognition and appreciation? My internet marketing business, I just sit behind a computer and, you know, there is no recognition or appreciation really in my internet marketing business. I just sit behind a computer. But in network marketing, I get to be in front of people and I get to help people. One of the coolest things about network marketing that you don't get in internet marketing is you don't make money unless they make money, all right? Think about that for a moment. That is the most ethical way to make money. You must help people to become successful in network marketing in order for you to make money in network marketing, which is why I love that so much. In internet marketing, we're all about the transaction. Network marketing is a heck of a lot more fun than internet marketing. I get to travel. I have never traveled more in the past 6 years than I have in my life since I've joined the network marketing profession. And it's just been a lot of fun. I traveled about 3 months out of the year. Half of that time is with Joel. We travel all around the world together with our families. So I just want to tell you guys, we're going to talk about blogging. We're going to talk about internet marketing. But never lose sight of why you're doing that. Never lose sight of why you're blogging, because you're going to be tempted to. Look at this photo. This is to me, encapsulates internet marketing and MLM. So the guy is sitting with his wife, who represents MLM,
and he sees a hot girl passing by, internet marketing. So he's getting seduced by the girl, and that's what internet marketing will do to you. All right? You need to be very, very careful about doing internet marketing while you're doing network marketing, that you don't get seduced away from your MLM business. So let me talk to you for a moment again about blogging and building a downline. So I'm going to give you the real, raw, unadulterated truth. Blogging and internet marketing are not the silver bullet for building a network of people that know you, like you, and trust you. It is not the silver bullet. I'm going to give you a warning. There are some perils of internet marketing and MLM. Number one, there's a very steep learning curve. Yes, there is a steep learning curve in internet marketing, and it takes a while to go through that learning curve. Not so in network marketing. Network marketing is a very, very simple business. You can make it difficult, but in its essence, in its core, it's very simple. Internet marketing can get very technical very fast. It can be all-consuming. I know internet marketers that they eat, sleep, and drink behind their computer. It can become all-consuming. And in internet marketing, you always want to build a better mousetrap. You want to build a different landing page. You're always testing, and you're always doing this and this, always trying to build something new and better. While in network marketing, you could have just gone out and talked to more people and made money directly. So what I've seen a lot of people happen is that they lose interest in their network marketing business when they start doing internet marketing. And this is something that the internet marketer and network marketers rarely ever talk about. And I've watched it from afar, and I can tell you that everything I'm saying here is the absolute truth. It is the truth, so you just got to be very careful about it. This is my own personal philosophy on recruiting. Nothing is really duplicatable. I mean, I know people that could never go to a networking meeting and shake a hand with somebody, that they don't have the courage to do that. That's not 100% duplicatable. Doing advertising is obviously not 100% duplicatable. Blogging, what I'm going to show you today, is definitely not 100% duplicatable. Postcard marketing, doing home parties. I try and get my wife to do a home party, and you know, she's not with it. It is not, you know, it's, none of these things are 100% duplicatable. So you got to work within what you're comfortable with, within your own skill set. Latch on to something that you know that you can do, and then you bring them into your company's funnel. This is the duplicatable part. So you get their interest. Just like Mr. Crowther said, you pique their interest. And once they're interested, then you put them in your company's duplicatable system through different exposures. Every company has a system for doing that. And this is my philosophy. Some of the successful traditional network marketers might disagree with me, and that's okay. But this is my philosophy on recruiting. And so when should you start blogging? Well, you shouldn't do it when you're first starting out in network marketing. That's a guarantee. And I never suggest you teach it to your brand new recruits. That's your death knell, all right? You bring them into the company's recruiting system, and you work within the company's system. If you get up to a certain level, and you feel like you're ready to do that, and you're making a bunch of money, then perhaps it's time to broaden your horizon, expand your knowledge, and do that. And by the way, you know, when Eric wanted to, you know, reach out to do something beyond traditional network marketing, what did he choose to do? Build a blog. That was the first thing that he decided to do. Okay, so I'm going to tell you just one more thing, and I'm going to get off my soapbox about this stuff. Don't be that guy. Don't be that guy. I don't know if you guys have seen this in the past couple years. People advertising, your upline is lying to you. What your upline doesn't want you to know. You don't own your own business, the company does. 7 dirty MLM lies your company feeds to you. I hate that crap. That pisses me off to no end because it damages our profession. You're hurting people. You're hurting good, honest people when you advertise like that. You can achieve the same results by doing positive advertising. So those of you who are out on the internet, and those of you who are here live, I'm going to respectfully ask you to stop doing any negative marketing if you're doing that right now. And don't do it. Don't do it. And for you guys that are teaching the profession to do it, please stop it. Because you're hurting our profession. You're hurting a lot of great people. Your upline's not lying to you. You do need to go out to your family and friends because you got to get a check in their hand immediately. And you're not going to do that via internet marketing. All right? All right, off my soapbox. What I'm going to tell you guys is going to be, the rest of this presentation is going to be like a fire hose. I'm going to give you tons of websites, links, and, you know, we're going to go deep very fast, okay? So I don't want you to take notes. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to build a cheat sheet for you this weekend, and I'm going to put every website, everything I mentioned, every link on a cheat sheet for you and make sure that we have it for you before you guys leave this weekend. There's going to be a lot of stuff I'm about to go over, so strap yourself in because we're about to go deep, all right? All right, so why do you want to blog? The first reason why you want to blog is to build your reputation, build your platform. Go outside of your friends and family and sphere of influence and expand it, okay? Number one, to build your reputation. The second thing is to generate buyer leads. And we'll talk about what a buyer lead is a little bit later. It's someone who buys something from you. All right. I like to talk to people after they have bought something from me and not just someone that has opted into my list, who registered for my list. So it's generate buyer leads. The third thing is to build an asset. Okay. For one reason or another, companies come and go. And you want to build something that you know is going to be there for a long time for you and that's going to serve your purposes for a long time. If you build a really good blog, like Network Marketing Pro, I mean, take that blog for instance. Whether Eric comes and goes in his current company or decides not to do network marketing for a while and just teach it, decides to come back in somewhere else, he's always going to have this brand that's going to make him millions of dollars, okay? So while you're using this as a recruiting tool, you want to build an asset that will always be a financial friend to you. And they all lead to growing your network marketing business. Don't forget that. We're studying how to do blogging so that you can do what? Build your network marketing business, not so you can be a full-time internet marketer. Okay? So here's a very high-level summary of my system, how I do it today. Very high-level summary. And by the way, I don't have my iPhone with me, but on my phone, I just looked at it today, and at 12:43 a.m., I registered a retail customer. Well, you know what I was doing at 12:43 a.m.? Well, I was not on the phone. I don't drink. I was sleeping. I was sleeping. And that happens about every day, every other day. I get a retail customer. And this is how I do it, okay? Someone sees my content on social media, which is LinkedIn, Facebook, or Twitter. They see my, or many other places you'll see in just a moment. They see my content out there on social media. They click on it. They click on the link, and it takes them back to my blog, back to my website, and they read my content. And my content is really good. So they read it. They start to trust me, and then they get to the bottom of my article, and I have a link there that offers them an interview, to buy an interview. So they either buy the interview, and the interview only costs $5. It's like hard to say no to it. Or they click on a link, and they sign up for my webinar. I have an automated webinar that plays 3 times a day. I use autowebinarplayer.com, and is the door open over here? That is loud. So they either hit my auto webinar or they buy an interview. It's an MP3 file with a PDF transcript and stuff like that. And when that happens, either me or one of my assistants picks up the phone and we call the person. And what do you think happens on the end of that line? Oh my gosh, you're Dave Fry? I can't believe you're calling me. I just purchased this thing. How are you calling me so fast? And so I get on the line. Now notice the difference between me calling somebody cold and me calling someone who's already been on my blog. They pulled out their credit card to spend money with me. They're excited to talk to me. Who's got the power in that conversation? I do. That is my system in a nutshell. It's very, very simple. And the interviews, see, I would tell you, go create your own product. But the fact is, 99% of you are not going to be able to create your own product. But can you interview somebody? You go interview somebody, you sell it for $5, you create a buyer lead, you call them up, and you talk to them. Okay, and I have a script that I go through. That's how my assistant does it. So again, I'm going to give you a summary overview, and then we're going to dive real deep into how I do this. Okay? So when I write an article on my website, the first thing I do is I go submit it I physically hand submit it to these particular sites: Facebook, Twitter, Dig, Pinterest, LinkedIn, StumbleUpon, and Google+. I hand submit it. Those are the big boys. I hand submit there. Okay? And then I'll go and hand submit to these other four entities. These are social media sites specifically for blogs and blog content. All right, the blog Engage, that's all automated. They take my RSS feed, which is they automatically pull the article from my site without me even doing anything the moment I post it, and they publish it. Okay, and then the third thing that happens is that I have a service like OnlyWire. And they pull my article too automatically, hands-free, I don't do anything. They pull my article, and they go send it to 40 social media sites. Okay? And then finally, we use something that I call content crowd sharing syndication. Those are big, long words. And basically what they are is they are services where people band together and share each other's content. Tribe Pro, I think there's a lot of network marketers in that one. Where's Ray Higdon? Ray, where are you? Stand up for a sec. He's a top earner in his company and a fantastic internet marketer. And by the way, he has a product called Pro Blog Academy. He knows way more about blogging than I do. Super smart guy. You've used Tribe Pro, right?
I have.
And have you had pretty good success with it? Okay. So these are just services that get a bunch of people together to share content. So you can see one article that I write goes out to a huge amount of sites. And that's called syndication, and that's what the name of the game is. You write your content and you syndicate it out all over the internet. And then people see it, they come back to your site, they read your article, they click on the interview link, they buy my interview for $5, I'm on the phone with them. You cannot build a network marketing business without getting on the phone. I don't care what anyone tells you. You must create relationships on the phone, okay, or in person. Now, it depends on how far you want to take them down the funnel before you actually talk to them, but that's my system in a nutshell. So there's five steps to doing this. One is to pick doing a blogging system. One is to determine what your topic is. The second one is to build your blog. The third is to create content. Four is promote that content. And five is to monetize the content. And we're going to go through each one of these steps, and we're going to go through them very quickly. Okay? First of all, what should the topic of your blog be? This is a question that I always get. Should your blog's topic be about network marketing or something else? And my answer is, I don't know. You have to decide that for yourself. I am of the opinion that you could have a blog about horses. You could have a blog about volleyball. And when people start following you, you become their guru, and you create a relationship with them, and they'll follow you no matter what you recommend to them. All right? So when I first started network marketing, I was doing internet marketing, and my product really didn't have a whole lot to do with hardcore marketing or business. But I had 120 people sign up in one weekend when I first started out. Why? Because they just followed. They were following me. So if you have a horse site and they love you, they're going to follow your recommendations, even if you have a health and nutrition network marketing business. Does that make sense? It should pass this test. And this is my test. This is the 10-year test. Whatever topic you decide on, are you ready and willing to dedicate a couple hours a day to writing content or creating content about that topic? So you've got to be passionate about that topic. So that's my 10-year test. Don't create a blog if you don't have, if it doesn't pass the 10-year test. What do you ultimately want to become known for? Do you want to ultimately become known as a guru in network marketing or something else? That's something you have to ask yourself. Is there something that uniquely qualifies you to talk about that subject? In other words, do you have a story to tell about that topic? That's not mandatory, but if you have a story, it makes you a lot more compelling. And what part or subtopic can you specialize in? So what I mean by that is the internet is made up of tiny little niches, all right? Even my blog is way too general. I basically started back in 2000, and so I could go general back then, but today, so like if you were starting a blog about network marketing, I would advise you do not start like a network marketing pro, okay? Here, Eric had a great reputation, a lot of people knew him. If you're gonna do it about network marketing, take one piece of network marketing and become the expert in that piece. So maybe you're the cold calling king in network marketing. Start your blog about that one topic. And you'll find when you do that, you'll be called upon to speak, people will start interviewing, your name will start going abroad, and you'll create a much more compelling presence with that small niche. Does that make sense so far? Okay, that's what I'm gonna tell you about your topic. Once you've selected a topic, then you wanna build your blog, all right? And there's lots of different options for building your blog, but basically, you can either A, choose a theme, and a theme is basically a design that's already laid out for you. It's something that's already been created. A second, you can build your design from scratch, custom. I built my blog custom because I knew exactly the design that I wanted. Or you can create a hybrid. So you can buy a theme and have it customized, and that would be a hybrid. But you also have to select what's called a framework. Okay, did I tell you we were gonna go deep here real quick? A framework basically allows the blog to be manipulated very easily. And there's lots of different frameworks. There's a Genesis, Elemental, Headway, Thesis, and many more. I use Genesis, it's very well known. It'll help your blog to be faster, it'll make it more flexible, and things like that, okay? So, let's talk about each one of these three options for building your blog. Let's talk about themes first. There's a lot of blog themes providers out there. Theme providers like WooThemes, ThemeForest, StudioPress, Elegant Themes. These are all different theme providers that you can go to their catalog of themes, look at them, choose the one you want, buy it, and then have it installed, okay? I'll give you a list of blog theme providers on our cheat sheet. So there's thousands of different themes out there. I've selected 12 of the best WordPress themes I think you should look at for your personal site. So I've kind of done a lot of homework for you and narrowed them down to 12 themes that I think you should consider. And again, I'm gonna give you this on the cheat sheet. This is from onedesigns.com. It's called the cover WordPress thing. One thing I think that you should really have is I want the content to be number one without a lot of big photos, all right, on the site. Just my preference. The mentor theme, we're just going to go through these. The canvas theme from Woo Themes. The personal press theme from Elegant Themes. That's a great theme right there. The basic theme from Elegant Themes. Generate from Studio Press. That theme right there is very, very popular in the blogging world. Okay. In fact, I'm going to show you one of the biggest bloggers in the world uses that theme. Balance from Studio Press. Focus from Studio Press. Writer from Theme Fuse. Marketer's Delight. I'll show you a hybrid of that blog in just a moment. And Nexus. Okay, these things don't mean anything to you until you actually start going out and building a blog. Then you're going to want to say, no, what were those 12 themes that Dave told me about? Because there's thousands of them. And these, I think, are the best. And then the streamline theme. So let's say now you've chosen your theme for your blog. Now you want to set up your new theme. There are companies out there that will set your theme up pretty fast. Superfastwebsites.com, I think it's $200. They'll set it up, they'll put all the plugins in it, and they'll hand it over to you. They'll put it on a host and they'll hand it all over to you. Empowered Blogs, they work in the network marketing industry. I think they charge $200, $300. Ninja Blog Setup is a very good company where they'll set your blog up. And Zach Johnson, he'll set your blog up for free. There are some guys out there that will set your blog up for free, just like the ones that are paid, if you use their hosting, because they get an affiliate commission, and that's where they make their money, okay? So those, if you just go, don't do any technical crap. Guys, do not do any technical stuff. Just go have someone install it for you the way that you want it, okay? So now let's talk about whether you want to custom design your blog. I custom design my blogs. The way that you do that is you either have a design contest. How many of you have ever used 99 Designs for design contests? A couple of you guys in here? Okay. So what these design contests do is you can go out there and you can put your requirements for a design and people will bid on that. Designers, they'll actually create designs for you. They'll do it all up front. And you'll have your choice of all these designs. And you pick one, and you only pay that person. You don't have to pay everybody else. Okay? 99designs.com. I had mine done at theperfectdesign.com. But you just post it out there, and you'll get all these designs. It's pretty cool. It's very cool. Or you can hire a designer. All right? You can go to studiopress.com/ whatever that says, whatever it says, and there's a whole list of developers that you can hire. Expect to pay between $3,000 to $4,000 for a designer to design your site and put it together. If you do a custom design, expect to pay about between $700 to $1,000 for a good design on a design contest. And then once you have that design, then you have to have someone code it. So there's companies like PSD to HTML, Code My Concept. These guys will take your design and then they'll code it into a blog. They'll put it all together for you. So if you want some custom design, that's how you do it. You don't have to do it yourself. You either do it through a contest, hire a designer, get a coder to put it together for you. Again, I'm going to put all these things down on the cheat sheet so you'll have it nice and handy when you want to go and do these things. All right, so let me talk about the elements of design that I think that you should have in a blog, all right? This is my blog. It's called marketingblogger.com, and I studied hundreds of different blogs before I designed this thing, and this is kind of what I came up with. So we'll talk about some elements of design. When you design your blog, you always want your most wanted response to lead the reader to opt into your site. Most wanted response comes from a guy named Ken Evoy, who's a pioneer in internet marketing. He taught this many, many years ago. When you design a site, you design that site to do one thing really, really well, and that is to generate a lead, okay? So the first and most important job of any website is to capture a person's contact information. Let me say that again. The first and foremost important job of any website is to capture someone's contact information, because usually, you know, 98 out of 100 people go to your website and they leave real quick. You got to capture their information. You cannot market to somebody that you cannot contact, right? Okay, so these are some example websites that do it really well. So let's take a look at some of these. All right, this is Amy Porterfield's site. Notice what is her most wanted response? Look at it. She wants you to sign up. Look, it's right there, front and center, above the fold. Here's one from Jordan Belfort. Who knows who this guy is? The Wolf of Wall Street. Anyone know who the Wolf of Wall Street is? You guys have read the book? All right, well, the movie's coming out next year. You gotta see the movie. That's his website. Notice he has a video, and it's probably to get him to opt in right next to his box. Okay, this is Ruth Zive, and she's a copywriter. Now, notice the design that she's using. That was one of our templates. Okay, so it has an opt-in right above the fold. This one's called Boost Blog Traffic. Look what he wants you to do. All right, notice these blogs are designed for one thing, to generate a lead, okay? And you want your blog to do the same thing. In fact, I'm thinking of altering my blog to do a better job at that right above the fold. This is Social Triggers. A friend of mine, Derek Halpern, his opt-in is right up there on the right-hand side. Remember I said there was a theme that one of the top bloggers in the world used? Chris Brogren is one of the top bloggers in the world. He's using a theme right there on his site. He's just customized it, so it's a hybrid, okay? Number two, the second most important job of any website is to get your visitor to connect with you on social media sites. You build an email list, and you build a list in social media. Okay, those are two of the most important things that you do with your website. I can see some of you guys sleeping out there, and trust me, I don't blame you. I probably would go to sleep on this stuff too. but when you start doing this, you'll become very, very interested in the stuff that I'm teaching you, because it took me years to figure this stuff out. So on Marketing Blogger, notice on the right-hand side, it's right up there in your face, like us on Facebook. And why is that? Because I get the majority of my traffic on Facebook. So in fact, if you were to look at all social media sites, you would see the traffic from Facebook is like, roar! And all the other sites put together, combined, is like, rrr. So Facebook to me is just huge, all right? So I try and get everybody to sign up on Facebook, or at least like my page, so that I can interact with them. And the fan page guy, where is he? All right, you're gonna be hearing from him this weekend. He's gonna show you just how important it is to get people to like your site on Facebook. Now, here's something really important. When someone opt into your site, they automatically go to another page called a thank you page. On the thank you page, you wanna get them to what? To get on your social media list. And the way that I do that, I don't know if I can do a, I touched the wrong button. So you'll notice here on the right-hand side, this is my thank you page. So after you register on marketingblogger.com, you come to this page. There's a video of me welcoming them and telling them a little bit about my life. I want them to know me as a person when they opt in to my site. You've got to personalize your site. And you'll notice these buttons right up on top. So I tell people, would you do me a favor and click that Facebook button? And also do me a favor, if you're on LinkedIn, would you click that LinkedIn button? So I get them to connect with me on all the social media, all these three big social media sites. It's so, so important, because when you publish your content, the name of the game is to get them to spread it. Well, how can they spread it if they're not seeing your content on social media sites? And they're not going to see it on social media sites unless they hit that button. So I want them to hit that button. So once I get them to opt in on my email, then I get them to connect with me on social media. Here's one of my other sites called TV Baby. It's a viral video website. Right up in the header, I've got the baby pointing to Facebook, because I want them to connect with me on Facebook, because that's how the viral videos go viral, through Facebook. My MLMCoachTV.com site, right up in the header, I want them to hit that button right up in the header and connect with me on Facebook. Okay, the third most important job of any website is to get the visitor to consume your content. Okay, this is the wrong way to do it. Now, I can put Paul's site, his name is Paul Lemberg, I can put his site up there because I'm working with him right now to fix this. But when you go to his site, there's a video of him right on the front page, and he's telling you all about him. It's all about him. Him. What do you want? You want your content to jump out. It's all about them. You want to make it all about them. So one of the most important things to get people to interact with your content is to put it right up in their face. When you go to Marketing Blogger, you're going to see I use big old fonts for my headlines because I want them to interact with my content. Okay? So the wrong way to do it is put a video right on the front page and talk all about you. The right way to do it is put content up front and center so that they'll go down, find a headline that clicks with their interest. They'll click in and read the article. Okay? That's Zach Johnson again. He offers a free to set up your blog for free. By the way, I know a guy who does this. He makes $18,000 a month on affiliate commissions from a hosting company because when you go to his site, this is the guy, when you go to his site, Smart Passive Income, he has a little place that says, this is where you need to start. I don't know exactly what it says. Don't know where to start? So he leads you where he wants you to go. And guess where that leads you? It leads you to a 4-minute video that shows you how to set up a blog on Bluehost, which is a hosting company. He makes $17,000 or $18,000 a month in completely passive income from that hosting company because he gets a bunch of traffic to his site. He has you click on that Get Started Now, and he has you sign up with Bluehost. So that's how important it is to get people to interact with your content. Okay, the next thing you want to do is get people to share your content. Again, the name of the game is getting people to share your content with other people. You've got to share it to thousands of people. So when I do an article, that's one of my article pages, you'll notice that right under the headline, I have the social media buttons. But at the bottom of my article, look what I'm doing at the bottom of my article. I actually asked them, if you enjoyed this article, please share it, tweet it, and Google Plus it. Because when that happens, that starts the viral effect, and that's where everyone starts to see my content. When you go to Network Marketing Pro, and I told Eric to make his buttons bigger, but Eric's got 50, how many people? 54,000 people have liked his site. That means when he publishes that video, it's going out to a ton of people. And then when they see it and they like it, guess what they do? They share it. And that's how he's gotten 54,000 likes on his site, and he's never done 1 cent of paid advertising. Man, that's a lot. That is a lot. So he's been extremely successful. And you know why it is? Because he puts out dang good content. That's why people want to share his stuff, because it's great content. So here's a site I used to own, givingpraise.com. We built that within 10 months. We got it up to about 130,000 likes on Facebook. It was growing really fast, and it was a distraction for me, and I sold it. But notice what I'm doing. When they watch the video, I have a little message under there that says something like, I can't even read it, but it said, hey, if you like the video, click the like button. Because then that video gets posted on their Facebook newsfeed for all their people to see. All right? So you really want to get people to share your content. This is a plugin called DimDim, and it just has your social media sharing bars on the right-hand side or left-hand side of the article. All right, the fourth most important job of any website is to get the visitor now to interact with you and other visitors. Now you need to create community. All right, and one of the best ways to do that is have a really good commenting system. In fact, I had Eric change his commenting system to a Facebook commenting system because he was getting a lot of people to it and they were making a lot of comments, but those comments were not going viral. Well, when you put the Facebook comments in, when someone makes a comment, if they keep the little checkbook, the check mark box clicked, it'll go out on their newsfeed. So every time someone makes a comment, it goes viral, and it increases traffic. I use the Comment Love commenting system, and again, you can use the Facebook commenting system. So in comments, it's almost like a mini forum, where when someone makes a comment, you come in and comment back, and you have like a conversation with them. Now Eric's too busy to comment to other people. So he lets his people talk. Do you ever comment back to him?
I comment,
yeah, okay.
Nobody else comments for me.
But it's kind of cool because he's got community because they're all talking to each other on it. He posts his, how many of you have made comments on some of his videos? Look, see? He's got you in his community. And that's the way to do it, okay? And then you got these little pop-ups that you can put on your site that actually ask to talk to people right there in real time. And this is a little widget called from VCETA that will allow you to do that. So you'll notice at the bottom right of his site, when you get down to a certain part of the site, this thing will pop up and it'll ask for a conversation. Again, what's the number one goal of your website? What? Generate a lead. That is the number one thing you want to happen on your site. So you want to put all these little things around your site that will generate a lead. The final thing that's the most important part of your website is to get people to fall in love with you. And the way to do that, the best way to do that, is to kind of do what I did at the very beginning. I showed you my personal life. I opened up my vest and let you into my personal world. And you kind of got to know me a little bit. How many of you felt like you knew me a little bit better after watching that video? All right? I could have sat here and talked for 3 minutes or however long that was, and it never would have done the job that that video did. And so your About Me page is very, 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 very important. You guys, write this down. Go to marketingblogger.com and go read my About Me page. It's long. It's a soap opera. I tell you the good, the bad, and the ugly about me. And you would be amazed at how many people read that thing all the way to the bottom. They want, people are natural voyeurs. We want to look in, peep inside the windows of other people's lives. And that's how you develop relationships with people, and that's how they get to like you and stuff like that. In fact, how many of you have ever realized or noticed that the more someone tells something bad about their life, the more you kind of fall in love with them? You know, Princess Di, she became super popular when she finally admitted that she committed adultery and was bulimic. Everyone, her popularity just soared when that happened. So I'm not saying don't throw all your dirty laundry out there, but I'm just saying go read my About Me page. You'll see what I'm talking about. I don't put any super damaging stuff, but it shows you a little piece of my life, okay? Another good example is Clay Collins' blog. Go to marketingshow.com, click on the About Me page there, and just read it. It took me a couple days to write that page, and you should take that amount of time. In the video that you saw, I have it at the bottom of that page. Okay, let's move forward. So now we have the blog constructed. Now we want to use plugins. Most of you know what a plugin is. It's just a little function that a blog does. And WordPress is set up so that you can either buy or download for free these little plugins that do certain things in your blog. And that's what makes WordPress so cool. All right, so here are 12 very helpful plugins that you should consider using. Number one, an editorial calendar plugin. I think one of the most important things you can do is create a publishing calendar for your blog. The second one is called AuthorSure. And this is, have you guys been searching Google recently and saw little pictures of people? Have you seen that? It's a brand new test that Google is doing to show authorship on content. And I'll tell you, it'll dramatically increase the amount of click-throughs that you get in the search engines if your little photo shows up. This plugin allows you that your little photo to show up in the search engines, AuthorSure. WP Touch, what that allows you to do is show your blog on a mobile device. I don't know, maybe the internet guys know. What percentage of people come to your site nowadays that are from mobile? Anybody know? It's a lot. It's like 30% of the people or 40% of the people that come to your site come through mobile now, and it's only getting higher. So your site's got to be very mobile ready. That WP Touch, you activate it, boom, makes your site mobile. It's really cool. Google Analytics, it'll just tell you stuff about your site. So like, let's say you publish an article and you want to come back and see how many visitors you had to that article, how long they stayed on that article. If you got an opt-in on that page, you can tell how many people opted in. So it just gives you analytics on specific pages. W3 Total Cache speeds up your site. The Hello Bar is a little bar that pops up at the top of your site. You can put one call to action in there if you want to lead somebody to do something. It's great for generating opt-ins. All right, Hello Bar, it's very popular. Related posts, you know, you're doing a lot of writing and your writing goes into the archives and you want some way to get people to go to that archive content. Related posts will do that. Backup Buddy, you better have that. If you don't back up your site, you're going to find one day you really wish you had. Bulletproof Security plugin that helps your blog to be secure. The Akismet, that is to stop spam. And the Comment Love, again, that's my commenting platform. I like Comment Love. That'll help you stop spam as well. And the Opt-in Skin plugin. So at the end of your site, what do you want people to do? And at the end of your article, what do you want someone to do? Opt in, because what's the number one goal of your site? Generate a lead. So you use Opt-in Skin, and you can put those at the end of your articles, and they will not only put the social media buttons there, but they'll put a nice little opt-in box. And finally, PrettyLink plugin. This is if you have a very long URL and you want to shorten it. You use PrettyLink plugin. And so that's how to build your blog, okay? So now you've got your blog all built, and you're ready to write content. I'm not going to give you the whole 36 sources for blog post ideas. Eric, where are you? How much of your day do you spend thinking about what content you're going to create the next day? Really? Does it come that easily? Come on. I mean, how many episodes you got? I mean, after 660 episodes, don't you, you know, sometimes think, well, what am I going to say tomorrow? All right, well, he's a guru. That's why he's the guru. But sometimes you're going, man, what am I going to write about? What am I going to do a video about? So these are some different ideas that you can use. You look in your comments. You get ideas from the comments from your readers. You ask your readers questions. You look inside discussion forums inside your own niche. Just being on Facebook and Twitter, I come up with a bunch of ideas of things to write about. YouTube videos. Sometimes when I'm stuck, I'll go to Amazon.com. I'll put in a keyword at Amazon.com. I'll look at the titles of the books, and I'll get an idea. Sometimes I'll click into the table of contents. I'll get an idea. Google Alerts. This is something that you really should do if you want to always have ideas of things to write about in your blog. Go to Google Alert, put a keyword in, sign up for it. They'll send you all the news for that day. Other blogs that you read, trade journals, over at LinkedIn, you can look at their answers. Going to seminars here. How many of you guys have written down a bunch of stuff that you think you could write an article about now? I don't know if you saw me earlier, but when Brendan Burchard was talking, I had a little video camera there, taping content for my blog. Eric does that a lot. You know, when he goes to a seminar and stuff, I've watched him before. He brings his little video camera, and he'll videotape everything. Every time I see him do it, I'm like, crap, how come I'm not videotaping that? He's always got his radar antennas up for new content, new ideas. These are just some other things that you can look at to spurn your thoughts on about what to write about. Because I'll tell you, if you're creating a blog, you're constantly on the lookout for new and different topics or ideas to write about constantly. Because now you're like a newspaper publisher. That's what you are. You're a publisher. And you're publishing content. You got to create new and different content all the time. So I'm going to give you a list, again, my checklist. And you'll be able to look at this from time to time, and it will help you. Now let's talk about the different types of blog posts. The different types of blog posts. You can do reader question blog posts. You can do surveys and polls and make those blog posts. Topical links. So you can go and find out what who are the top five income earners in network marketing. Go find that information. Slideshare posts. So you can do a PowerPoint presentation real quick and then upload it to SlideShare, and then from SlideShare you can put it in your blog post. I did that just the other day. I scanned some birthday cards that I had received and I put them in a PowerPoint. I uploaded to SlideShare and I'm writing an article about birthday cards and I'm going to put that in one of my posts. Podcast. Lessons learned. So when you guys come back from the seminar and you have these lessons learned, you can write some really good articles. Hey, what did I learn at GoPro? Cheat sheet, news, different checklists. People love checklists. Don't you like to receive checklists? It's almost kind of like, oh, it's done for me. I've got this checklist I can go down. People love to have checklists. So that's a good way, a good type of blog post. FAQs. Just common questions about a certain topic. Write the question, you write the answer, that becomes a blog post. So all these are different types of blog posts. Now videos, that's what Eric does. He has a vlog, a vlog, a video blog. How-tos, that's most of my writing. When you go to Marketing Blogger, you see most of my type of blog posts are how-to blog posts. Because at heart, I'm a trainer, all right? So that's what I write about. People profiles. Maybe you've met somebody here, and this is something, how many of you have a blog already? Wow, quite a few of you. So what I would suggest is meet new and different and interesting people here, maybe some of the speakers, and then call them up, find out something about them, and write a profile about them on your blog. Okay, what does that do? It develops relationships. So there's a reason that you're calling them now. One of the things that I wish I'd done earlier when I started out doing internet marketing, I wish I would have interviewed more people. Just done interviews with people. Interviews are some of the best ways to develop relationships with a lot of influential people. Okay, so these are just different types of blog posts. So I'm going to show you different types of video blog posts. How many of you like to do video? Video is pretty easy, and it develops a rapport and a relationship with your viewers or your visitors like nothing else. Really, I mean, when you think about it, the one thing that has sold more products in the world has been TV, been video. Video engages all the senses. So I like doing drive time videos. So if you jump in my truck, you'll see a little thing on the dash that holds my iPhone. So on the way to work, I'll do a little 3x5 card. I'll put my iPhone right in there, and I'll turn the thing on. As I'm driving to work, I do a video. Okay, when I get there, I download it, put it in my blog, and I'm good to go. I like doing walk-around videos. And I don't have it here, but it's called X-Shot. Go to xshot.com, and it's this piece of metal that you pull out, and it will hold your iPhone, and you can hold it, and it will videotape you. And it looks like that. Show it. There's X-Shot right there. That thing is awesome. It's only $25, and it creates videos that are just awesome, stunning. All right, so I walk around my block. When I do videos for my network marketing team, I do my walk around the block videos. I'm kind of known for that. You can do talking head videos, that's what Eric does. He usually does talking head videos. You can do demonstration videos. How many of you have seen these for the blender, blend it videos? They're hilarious. You can do in-person interview videos. There's Eric interviewing Richard Brooke. Or using Skype now. You were using Skype when you did this interview. You can call, most all computers have a webcam. So he called up Todd Falcone, and they did an interview right there. I'm telling you, doing interviews is awesome because you can develop relationships with these interviews. I think it's one of the best types of content because you kill so many birds with one stone. You can do screencast videos, PowerPoint presentation screencasts. You can do review videos. You can do live seminar footage. So when Brendan was doing his bit about clarity, I videotaped that with my little video recorder, about that whole clarity thing, and I hope you don't mind if I play that on my blog. It was only a little piece. And I've already wrote half the article about that. So I wrote half the article, and I took a little snippet of them. That's live video that I'm going to put on a blog post. Remember, you're always publishing content. Seminar interviews, okay? So don't be surprised if I stop some of you guys out in the hall and I say, you know, what's the number one thing that's helped you to build your network marketing business? And you give like a little 30-second or one-minute deal. And I take those and I send them to my organization and I put them on my blog, okay? Whiteboard videos. People love whiteboard videos. You have a whiteboard behind you and you start drawing all kinds of things. It keeps people engaged. These are just the different types of videos that you can put in your blog. Okay, how to write and format your content. This is very important. I know you guys are thinking, what? Man, he's going into formatting my article? You would be amazed at how much more shares I get simply because I format my content a little bit differently. So I start out my articles using a thing called Text Wrangler because I have a Mac. If you have a PC, you use TextPad. It's a simple text editor. I write my article, and then I put it in my blog, and I have this little thing that I use called Scribe, and it helps me to search engine optimize the content that I have in that article. I use lots of numbered lists and bullet points. Lots of numbered lists and bullet points. People's eyes, they can't just read chunks of text. It needs to be broken up. And so I use lots of lists and bullet points in all my articles, you will see. And rarely do I have an article that goes more than two lines. I use lots of subheadlines, again, to break up the text. It just makes it makes your article. Do you want them to read the whole article, or do you want them to read the first paragraph? If you want them to read the whole article, you got to break up your text. I use quotes, facts, figures, charts, graphics, things to break up. I do this in, I have this, what's the little application that records the screen, Joel? No, Snagit. I use a little thing called Snagit, and I will create stuff in PowerPoint, and then I snag it and save it as a graphics, and I put it, that thing took me less than a minute to create, that graphic right there, less than a minute. And again, you would be amazed. Putting little things like that in your content how much it allows you, people think, whoa, that's so cool, and they share it. Write like you talk. Use stuff like, are you kidding me? That's just plain crazy. I freaked out when I saw that. Guys and gals, I ain't lying. Holy guacamole. All right, use your personality in your writing. You put your personality in your writing. Do not write like a corporate drone, okay? And make your content epic. Awesome. I go back and I watch old videos. You know, I watched one, I don't know what number it was, Eric, the other day about leaving a company. It was, I don't know, like number 249. Because his content is epic. It's awesome. It's good. It's really, really good stuff. That's why he's got 50 plus thousand shares on or likes on Facebook. He just puts out great content. And you need to as well. These are some comments that I got back from a recent article I did. It's epic content. It's awesome content. That's how you get it shared. And guys, this actually does turn into distributors. It does. You write good content, you get it shared, someone sees it, they come back to your blog, they click on it, they buy that little article, you're on the phone with them. All right? It really does work. It's better to write one or two epic articles a week than to write mediocre articles every day. Why? Because people share great content. Remember that. People share great content. All right, I won't go through that guest post. Okay, so now you've created your blog, now you're writing great content, now it's time to promote it. And this is where the rubber hits the road. This is where you want to get your content out all over the net. The very first thing you want to do is kind of funny because it's network marketing. You want to create a network of influential bloggers in your niche. You want to get to know those people because a blogger in your niche might have a list of 15 to 20,000 people. You meet someone at a chamber, what's the rule, Joe Girard's rule of 250? That every person knows at least 250 people? Well, a blogger, how many people do you think know Eric Worre? At least 54,000. All right, so when you're tapping into Eric's network, you're tapping into a freaking oil well, right? It's huge. And that's what you want to do. So when you move into whatever you're writing about, go find out who the biggest bloggers are and start to develop a relationship with them. In fact, I would say pick out the 7 most influential bloggers in your niche. Comment on their blogs, buy their products, friend them on social media sites, promote their content, send them a testimonial, send them offline stuff. I had one day a guy in India send me a cake. Somehow he got a hold of a local cake maker and they had it delivered for my birthday. Okay, I will do anything for that guy in India now. I'm serious. Initiate a phone call with him. So that's, there's kind of like this hierarchical scale of relationship, and it starts out by someone just seeing your content somewhere on the net. They don't know much about you. And then it moves up once they go to your site, and then it moves up once they read your article. And then it moves up once they buy that little interview. And then it jumps way up when you get on the phone with them. And that's kind of how it works. Okay? So find out who those influential bloggers are and become friends with them. Okay, 13 things to do after you post your blog. You think that all the work's done after you post your blog. All right, Eric, he probably just posts his blog and goes on his merry way. Well, I'm going to show you 13 things that you need to do after you post that blog post, okay? Number one, you shorten your URL link because you're going to need to. You're going to need to shorten it. Again, I use PrettyLink. And then I take that link and I post it to Facebook, first thing I do. Well, I know Eric does that because I see his Facebook post. You post it to Facebook. Then you post it to Google Plus. You always want to post it to Google Plus because of that authorship thing. All right, so Google can say, all right, that piece of content belongs to David Fry. I'm going to put his picture on it. So you post to Google Plus. Then you post to Twitter. And then you post to LinkedIn. I do all these things manually. I do them all manually because these are big social media sites, and I don't want any Google or anyone thinking that I'm doing it automated. I do it manually. I post a dig. I post a stumble upon. This takes me no more than 15 minutes. So it looks like I'm doing a lot. Basically, it's taking a link, plugging in, taking a link, plugging it in, taking a link, plugging it in. If you got an assistant, they can do this. It's simple. I post to Pinterest. I post to Blog Interact. I post to BizSugar. And then I post to Social Buzz Club. And while I'm in Social Buzz Club, I share some other people's content. And then I gain points. And then they come back and share my content. And then I posted this thing called Send. I won't talk too much about it, but it's a service where there's a bunch of people out there in internet land that share my content, and I pay them to do that. And then finally, I send a newsletter email to my list, and I know that Eric does that too. All right, because that's what's going to get you a lot of traffic. You send a newsletter out. So I do all those things after I post. And I swear, the newsletter takes me about 10 minutes, but other than that, it takes me no more than 15 minutes to do those things. So then, my time is gone. It went black up here, so I don't know where I'm at. So again, as a summary, I take my content, I post it to those sites, OnlyWire does it automatically, and then a couple of these do it automatically, a couple of them I post to. And that throws my content out to thousands. All right, not thousands, hundreds of sites, which then go out to thousands of sites. And that's how you can spread your word out there. And if it's epic content, it's going to spread all over the internet. They're going to come back to your site. How many of you have heard of Fiverr? Okay. Fiverr, for $5, you can do some amazing things. So here's some Fiverr gigs to promote your blog. One of them will take your URL and post it to a bunch of social media sites and social bookmarking sites. Over on Fiverr, there's just some amazing things that you can do for $5. Absolutely amazing things you can do. I will post 7 quality blog comments, all done by hand. So this lady was going to go out to 7 blogs in your niche and post comments for you. When you post a comment on someone else's blog, they see it, some people will come back. For $5, that's Fiverr. Repurpose your content and then syndicate it. So now you got that article, let's read it into an audio player, record it, and then once you've got it recorded, you can make a PowerPoint and take the recording and the PowerPoint and make a video out of it and send it to all the video sites. These are $5 Fiverr gigs that do exactly that. You can give your audio file to that first Fiverr gig and they're going to create a PowerPoint out of it. And then the second Fiverr gig, you take the PowerPoint and the audio and you send it to them. She'll make a video of it, and then this person will take that video and put it out on all the video sharing sites. So you need to see how you're getting your content out even more just by repurposing. You can do the same with a podcast. You take that audio, you go to Podomatic, and you upload it there, and then some Fiverr gig will load it up to 14 other different podcast sites. From one article, you can literally spread your content all over the internet. And that's the key, to syndicate your content. All right, monetize. So again, this is where the rubber hits the road again. This is how I get a phone call. So I've syndicated my stuff. They see it, they click on it, they come back to my blog, they read an article. This is the bottom of one of those articles. All right? You'll notice in a PS, I say something like, hey, if you want more information about doing this, this, and this, click on this link. And that link takes them to a little sales letter, and all that's an interview that I did with a guy named Doug Westmoreland. Picked up the phone, recorded an interview with him, I sell it for $5, they buy it, and I pick up the phone and talk to him. Man, that's leads. I never run out of leads, never. And these aren't leads that you buy, man. These are people that know you, that trust you already. They're freaked out that you called them. All right? This is also an auto webinar. Now, this is at the bottom of an article. It says, a simple system for getting all the business referrals you can handle. And what that auto webinar does is it sells them on the retail service of my network marketing company. All right? So they're signing up, and I'm sleeping. When they sign up, I call them up. Like the guy who signed up at 12:40 a.m., I need to get on the phone and call that person. Okay, so again, these are the four steps. Social media, get them to click on my site, sell them a little thing, start talking to them. That's how I do it. All right, so what are you going to do on Monday morning? This was a lot of stuff, wasn't it? I told you I was going to go deep. So what do you want to do on Monday morning for those how many of you do want to start a blog? All right, wow, a lot of you. Okay, so this is what you do on Monday morning. I'm going to make it real simple for you. A, you pick your topic. Once you got your topic picked, go buy a domain name based on your topic. Then you go pick a theme. You take one of the 12 or 20 themes, whatever I had, pick a theme. Then you hire an installer. You pick one of those companies that I showed you. $200, they'll install the theme for you. One guy will do it for free. Then you create a publishing schedule. Start thinking of all the topics that you want to write about and create a big list of all the topics. Then you start writing. And you start promoting your writing through the social media sites. It really is not that difficult. Just don't do it yourself. Just hire people to do all the technical stuff for you. All you need to do is write and then start promoting your writing. Okay, so I'm going to give you some big tips to finish this thing off. A, get someone else to do the technical stuff. Did I just say that? Get someone else to do the technical stuff. You focus on creating epic content. So hire one of these sites, one of these services to do that stuff for you. Second, create a daily blogging schedule and stick with it. You don't have to blog every day. You can blog, you know, a couple times a week. But create a schedule and stick with it. So creating content, 1 hour. Promoting the content, 1 hour. Networking and promoting, half an hour. The rest, put it away and go out and do your traditional network marketing stuff. All right? So stick with that schedule. Certain time per day, do it every day during that time period. Again, create a publishing schedule. I'm telling you, if you create it, one of the best things I ever did for blogging was creating a publishing schedule. Because I know what I'm going to write about, you know, for the next 4 months. Always remember the purpose of why you're blogging. And why is it? It's not to become a full-time internet marketer. It's to build your network marketing business. Why? Because those $2 are not the same, my friends. They are not the same. You could do internet marketing, and 6 years from now, you'll still be doing the hustle. You do network marketing 6 years from now, and you could have beach money. You can be building schools in third world countries. You can have the things that you've always wanted to do, contribute to the causes that you've always wanted to do. But if you get seduced into full-time internet marketing, you're going to be doing the hustle. And this is just my opinion. Don't teach internet marketing to your organization because it's going to kill your check. You know, if people want to do it at a certain time period, I tell them, you know, go buy someone's course. You want to learn about blogging? Go buy a Pro Blog Academy course. You know, I'm not going to teach it to you. Go buy, there's a course there that you can buy. Go teach it, go let Ray Higdon teach it to you. Six, always have your radar up to observe things for great content ideas. If you're writing a blog, by the way, of network, I remember one time Jordan Adler, you know, Jordan, he does a call every Monday evening for his network marketing company. And I remember talking to him about that one time because I did calls and then I stopped calls because everyone else was doing calls. He says, Dave, one of the reasons I do those calls because it keeps me sharp. Keeps me sharp. I'm always thinking about new and different things to train my organization. It keeps me sharp. So always have your radar up. Okay, I'm going to leave you with my all-time favorite quote. And if you remember nothing from what I shared with you today, I want you to remember this quote. It's by a great man whose name was David O. McKay. And this quote has really had a huge impact on my life. And this is the quote. No success can compensate for failure in the home. So all you guys that are out there trying to reach your dreams and hustling to build your network marketing business, just remember that if you do that instead of being a good daddy or a good mommy or a good husband or a good wife, it's all for naught. No success you'll ever achieve will ever compensate for being a failure in your own home. So always make your family a priority in your life, and you'll be surprised everything will fall into place for you. Thanks, you guys.